morning. Here I am at Graceland, day four. I can't believe it. 4 days in a row at Graceland. Talk about living the dream. Man, I'm living a dream. Me and a couple hundred, maybe a few thousand people already hanging out this morning saying hi. I signed up to take what's called the barn tour. They do it all day, all the way through Labor Day. You can jump on a tour bus and come around the backside of Graceland and see stuff that the public doesn't usually get to see. A collection of horses. One of them is actually a descendant of one of Elvis's own horses. Graceland right here. Elvis bought this from a lady named Ruth Moore. Ruth Moore happened to be the granddaughter of Stephen Tooth. Stephen was the original owner. This was 500 acres of pastures and farmland, Civil War era mansion. He had a daughter named Grace. She was a great musician, played the harp. That's how it gets its name, Graceland. Once Elvis moved in, he made it the capital of rock and roll. Y'all hang with me today. We got lots of fun stuff to do. Let's have a good time. Dig this. The front entrance to the barn, man, listen, there's billions and billions of Elvis fans all over the world. Not even half of them have seen this view. You guys are getting a treat right here, and so am I. Hey, check this out. Each one of these chairs has the name of a horse. You look over there, see Emily and Flaming Star, some names that the Elvis fans recognize. But right here is Tucker, Candy, Bandit, and Max. Those are the horses that are here on Graceland grounds right now. Check it out. T. That's taken. C, that's care. B is business. And you turn that M sideways, bam, you got a flash. TCB in a flash. If I'm nervous, will he attack? Will
no,
he,
he's not going to attack.
Will he bring out his claws?
Oh, no.
Like a velociraptor.
He may lick you today.
Like a velociraptor. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy.
He may lick you, but hey. he's not going to attack.
Horsey. Here you go. Here you go, buddy. All right. Hanging out here on the private side of the barn, it's not included in the tour. This is like the barn. Like if you live at Graceland, this is where you hang out. I'm talking about somebody. You know, there's horses everywhere around me. Right here, I just want to show you this one horse. This is No Candy, Just Cash. They call him Candy. He's taking it easy this morning. He's had an hour-long massage, a warm bath. They've been feeding him cookies all morning. The reason they treat him so special is because he is like the great, great, great grandson of one of Elvis's horses, Ebony's Double. This horse right here is like a prized possession. They treat him like a son in his own house. I salute you, Candy. Man, he's got the life. Look at this. How come I can't lay around in hay, guys? Wow, what a great way to start the morning hanging out at Elvis's barn, meeting all of his horses. Look at this beautiful backside view of Graceland. But man, there's so much stuff going on next door. I'm talking about a book signing, a dance party tonight. Man, y'all come on, let's go. This is easy. Hello, welcome to Graceland.
Hey.
Hi, welcome to Graceland.
Hey.
Welcome to Graceland.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Welcome to Graceland.
Thank you.
Hey, can you give me like some crazy, like give me some moves, some real Elvis moves. Get this. Here we go. Yeah, give me some moves. Sell it. Come on. Make it rock.
Oh.
Wow. Cool. Check it out. A few dozen more people gonna come and visit Graceland. Down here is the guard shack. Everybody that comes to Graceland goes by the guard shack. And you don't think about the guard shack when you're buying your plane ticket, planning your vacation to visit Memphis for Elvis week, but it's all part of the legend and the lore. Once Elvis moved in here, he got his cousins, his uncles, relatives from Mississippi to come and join him here, giving him jobs, letting him live the good life with him he loved to share. This is the gate where Elvis would pass those autographs through, screaming teenagers lining up and down what we now know as Elvis Presley Boulevard. Used to just be the highway down to Mississippi. I'm telling you, man, it's all part of the legend. It's all part of the story of Elvis Presley. Right here, a couple hundred names of people who know exactly what I'm talking about. Are you one too?
Hey, my name is Monica, and I'm a big Elvis fan. Are you?
Hi, I'm Michael Lewis. I'm an Elvis fan. Are you?
$1.5 trillion in one day right here. How in the world can Elvis Presley sell more records every year than he did the year before? How long can this go on and how big can it grow? You're the missing piece. Come on down to Elvis Week. I got this.
2 o'clock tour number 7. Please come to the
That's me.
Boarding area.
That's me, 2 o'clock tour. I'm out of here. Thanks, guys.
You know this is the man right here.
How you doing?
I'm doing well.
You doing good? How's everybody? Doing good? Feeling good? There are very few entertainers that inspire this level of commitment. Here we are, Elvis Week 35. If anybody feels like standing up and doing a little bit of Elvis, if anybody wants to sort of give it to the camera. That's great.
Well, what did you think once he got out there and did what he does?
Well, I was in the dressing room. I'd been on, of course, and he went on, and I heard all this screaming, and my daddy kind of got alarmed. He said, I wonder if there's a fire. Well, you see, there's never been anything like that in music
wow.
before.
Amazing. Look at this. Look, hold on just for a second. Can you see this? Look at this. Look at this energy right here. How lovable. Fantastic. What
well,
a great picture.
Well, he was lovable. Well, I'm pretty lovable, too.
I hear you.
I'm one of only three women to ever record with him, and this was the song,
wow.
Signs of the Zodiac, from the film.
Wow.
Girl.
How hip. Signs of the Zodiac.
Yes.
We were standing around a microphone, and there were four girls. And of course, we're all really young, and we were trying to get the parts down.
You were just working out the parts.
Yeah, we're working at the
just
parts.
A day at the office.
And then about 1,000 guys walked in the door, and out of the center of them walks Elvis Presley, and goes, we're sitting there going,
really?
You know, and with our mouths, he came right over to us, you know, and
yeah.
They shook our hands. He said, hello, I'm Elvis Presley. And we just all went,
oh, he would have never known that.
Are you a big Elvis fan? I gotta ask you.
I'm a huge Elvis fan. Absolutely.
What was it like when they called and said, Israel Jane, yo, you're the co-host?
Well, I started screaming like a girl.
Show us. Gail Starrett sitting right next door. Gail, if there is one biggest Elvis fan, it might be you. You've been here at Graceland every year since when? The 90s? Oh no, 80s? Keep talking, go ahead, go.
72.
You come to Graceland yearly because you love Elvis that much?
I do, yes.
All right. Here we are, we're at Graceland, can you believe it? And we're about to meet Jerry Schilling. I mean, this guy was a personal close friend of Elvis. He's worked with the Beach Boys or Jerry Lee Lewis. I mean, he's worked with rock and roll royalty, and we're gonna meet him in just a minute. In fact, let's go look for him.
Hi there, I'm fine, thanks.
We're looking for Jerry Schilling. Have you seen Jerry Schilling?
No, I have not seen him anywhere, no.
Has anyone seen Jerry Schilling? We're looking for Jerry Schilling.
Yes.
Hey, have you guys seen Jerry Schilling anywhere?
Yes, at the Elvis Insiders.
Elvis Insiders, well, where's that?
It's that way.
All right, here we are. We're in Graceland, and we're still looking for Jerry Schilling. We've been looking everywhere. Have you guys seen Jerry Schilling?
What?
No, they don't know. They haven't seen him. Hey, we're looking for him everywhere. And
I'm Jerry Schilling. I heard you were looking for him.
Well, I have, sure have. We've been looking all over the place. It's an honor to meet you.
This place was the safest place I ever lived, Israel, in my life.
That's awesome.
You know, you think of Elvis and you think of rock and roll and the 50s and the wildness, and we certainly had some nice parties here downstairs, but outside of that, this place was so peaceful.
Hey everybody, I'm Gail. We're here at the Elvis Week Dance Party. Come on in, we're gonna talk to a few people, do a little bit of dancing, have a good old time.
I'm an Elvis fan, my name is Sophie and I'm six.
Where are you from, Tom?
From Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Western Canada.
Wow, you came a long way.
Yeah, a couple miles.
I'm an Elvis fan. How about you?
Yes!
Woo!